Tony Hirone on the cello. And Miss Maria Im on the violin.
And Jonathan's.
And speaking of incredible women, you all got to spend some time with her already. Did she melt your face?
Yes.
Please welcome back to the stage, Miss Emily King.
She covered up yet? It's still cold, man.
She loves jogging.
And she exercise for the day.
That's great. Well, you look great. Whatever it is, it's working.
Really out of breath.
Yeah. Was she not just the most amazing? I was watching, you know, the dressing rooms are like right there and you're just peeking, watching the whole time. And you guys were such a fucking amazing audience for her as well.
Thank you.
The shit, San Diego.
Legit.
Legit the shit.
Yeah, the shit.
We're songwriters, it just happens. Legit. I got French for a second, but follow the muse.
International album.
That's what they call those.
She's probably finding some people.
She's making an international album.
It's amazing.
Yeah, everyone's just like.
Hi. Emily and I are friends, if you can't tell. We're also neighbors in New York City.
Oh, nice.
And thank you. I love
weird,
neighbors.
That's
too.
A big town.
That's a big town. The fact that we landed a block apart is awesome.
It's creepy on your part.
Yeah, it is. What do you mean?
No, I'm just saying you just showed up one day.
Hi. You live here too?
Nice. In the apartment.
In the apartment. We should talk about that.
But it worked out.
But it did work out. Because I fucking love her.
I love and, you. Give it up for Beans. Sarah Morales.
Thanks, Bobby. We wrote a song together that I just love on the new record, and she said she'd sing it with me, so here we go.
You don't have to ask twice.
Don't have to ask twice, yeah. Just have to bring you on tour, the whole fucking thing. You don't have to ask twice. Anyway, it's called If I Can't Have You.
Nice.
Like, you mean like the monsters?
Oh, yes, exactly.
I'm ready. I don't seem ready, but I'm ready.
You tell me that you're leaving. You say the time will slowly leave. Oh, this heart that I place into your hands. I held it out. Give it back. What am I supposed to do? Oh, I had a feeling.
Take a brief moment and just acknowledge our incredible, incredible, incredible crew. You're watching them run around and make us look and sound good for you. They are just unbelievable human beings on top of being incredible technicians. So just thank them with us.
Yeah!
Maybe I should just be a sound tech.
That's true. You get to carry guitars and Sarah Brown.
I've been away from this singer-songwriter thing for a little while, and one of the things that happened while I was away is that I fell in love.
Nice.
And I know! It's awesome.
Yeah.
Turns out.
Wow.
All these years I've been hearing about it. Anyway, mm-hmm. It's awesome, and he's awesome, and we fell in love kind of in over a summertime up in Boston. And we listened to a lot of Nina Simone. Smiles in the morning at me, apartment on the second story, strangers in a brand new city. Both remembering last night, kitchen table and a bottle of wine. Only thing on my mind is
settle in, and we'll throw on some Simone. sounds like. And I blow this candle on a rooftop in the moonlight. Someday when we're old and gray, sifting through our yesterdays, we'll pull that memory from its sleeve and play this song.
I've been away, and the main reason I was away is that I've spent the last 6 years working on a musical theater project called Great Show. Here we go. Did you see this on tour?
Yeah! Next time.
I moved to New York City, and I said yes to this crazy thing that I grew up on musical theater. It's one of the first loves of my life. And I was looking for a reboot of sorts, and I had no idea what I was saying yes to. If I knew, I would have said no.
Oh,
it's a lot of work, it turns out. But it has been the greatest and most fulfilling artistic journey of my life. I have met incredible people, and I'm so proud of the work that we did together. And we have a Broadway show that is coming to a close. We've had an incredible 4-year run on Broadway. We've had a national tour. We have a production in the West End. There's a production in Australia, in Japan, in the Netherlands. It's beyond my wildest dreams. So it felt only appropriate that we spend a little time inside the Songs of Waitress.
See, the musical comes to you, man.
See her, my mother.
whole meaning of life in those sad eyes. They've seen things you can never quite say, but I hear. Come out of hiding, I'm right here beside you. And I'll stay there as long as you let me. Because you matter to me. Simple and plain and not much to ask from somebody.
Stop racing, let's face it, making mistakes.
the thing and everything.
Nice.
Shit, man.
It felt like I wanted to sort of close the, we call this part of the show the waitress suite. We're a very dignified bunch. And I wanted to conclude with the place where it all began for me, which was in a little apartment in the West Village in New York City in January, right after I had moved there. Which, for any of you thinking about moving to New York, don't fucking do it in the winter, because that's just dumb. I'm like, I lived in LA. I'm like, that's fucking awesome. And then I like go, and it's just like shit. The world is just shitting on you, and it's cold. I'm like, oh, all right. I guess that's what this is gonna be. And I was completely uprooted my entire life. Didn't really know anybody there. Had just said yes to like trying to write a fucking musical, had no idea what I was doing, and thankfully found kinship in the lead character of this beautiful, beautiful story written by Adrienne Shelley, who sadly is no longer with us, but she wrote and directed the film, and really gave me this beautiful person who was in the middle of a life that she did not recognize, and I found so much comfort in that. And I ended up writing a song sort of for the both of us, and it's called She Used to Be Mine. It's not simple to say most days I don't recognize me. These shoes and this apron, that place and its patrons, I've taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be. Oh, it's true, I was never attention's sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken and won't ask for help. She is messy, but she's kind. She's lonely most of the time. She is all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be slips in through that door and carves out a person, makes you believe it's all true. Now I got you. You're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all. Finally reminds her to fight. so much. I sound so pretty when you sing. A little band of angels.
Oh, shit.
Every time, come back here.
Are you guys doing okay? You having a good time? Thank you. Thank you. I want to introduce you to my good friend and incredible musician, Mr. Rich Hinman on the guitar. And if you were hoping that there was a point in the set where you were going to be able to stand up, this is the point in the time I want to invite you guys. Stand up and shake it off, you know. There's a lot of energy to be shared on our feet as well.
Yeah.
And thank you for being an absolutely amazing audience already, Cindy. Oh.
you wanna say? Let the words fall out. Honestly, I wanna see you be brave. What you wanna say is let the words fall out. Honestly, I wanna see you be brave.
Thank you from the bottom of my heart for being just a fucking amazing audience. Woo! I want to say another thank you to Emily King for joining us on this wonderful tour.
Yeah!
This song has a lyric that became the namesake of the album, and it was originally written as a prayer to myself to find a way to return to a place of love amidst the chaos and the volatility and the fear and the hate and all of the extraordinary sadness that we see on a daily basis. To come back to a place that reminds me that we are our own sources of light and we can be a source of light for other people. So thank you for being an incredible bright star tonight for us.
Yeah.
This is called Orpheus.
Come by the fire, lay down your head. My love, I see your growing tide. Set the bad day right a bed.
Stay here.
This is not everything. Nah, Sarah Brown was like,
Encore!
I realize it's a retreat.
on the drums. Misty Boyce on keys, guitar, and singing. Melody Huron on cello. It's Maria Im on violin. And Miss Butterfly Boucher on guitar, bass, and thang. We got one more for you. Thank you for an extraordinary night. Yeah. Really, from the bottom of my heart. Thank you, San Diego.
Thank you. you so much, everyone. Good night.
Did I drop my headphones?
No, I haven't.